quick. You know, I came to Agua Fria today and I stumbled into a party. We got a full-blown party going on at Agua Fria. That is unbelievable. Normally you're up here by yourself, but today, man, we've got a bunch of people with us today. So what we're gonna do today is somewhere I've wanted to go for a long time, and that is the Brooklyn Mine. So what I've decided to do was come down this embankment, and I'm thinking maybe that wasn't a great choice. So I think I'll work my way over here, and then what we'll do is we're gonna work our way over to that mine that's right down there. Now that road looked like it ended down there. So what we're gonna do is we're parked up here. We're gonna come down this hill and see if we can't get to the mine today. Now, one thing that we've got going is we are way behind on schedule. I didn't get down here till about 1:30. So we're gonna have to truck this thing pretty good. And we're gonna have to really go fast or we're not gonna get where we're gonna get today. So we're gonna make our way down this hill right here. Man, I smell the hot dogs and the hamburgers. Normally I come down here and I'm all by myself. So this is kind of unique to be able to come in here and see all these people. And we're gonna work our way down here. And this is a lot steeper than I thought it was, but it is what it is. So we need to just start quitting talking and getting the hiking. You know, I might have chosen a different route. I didn't remember this being, as always, as hard as it was. So if I wouldn't already be through halfway through these stickers, probably what I'd have done was just taken a road. That'd have been like 20 times smarter and easier. And that might be what I do on the way back. So what we're on the trail of today is a mine, the Brooklyn Mine. And I've seen these remnants down here before, and I always wanted to go to them. Now, there's also a lot of Indian ruins down here as well. So the ancients spent time down here, but we're gonna study the mine today. That's the goal. And we're gonna kind of stay on track today and try to make sure that we're safe, we're slow. We get it done, even though I'm hauling pretty strong. I should find a soft, easy path and use that way, but this should be an absolutely excellent day. And like I said, I think I'll try a different way out. Looks a lot better over there than it did this steep. Man, I picked the steepest part, but isn't that the way it usually goes? So what I'm gonna try to do is make sure that I pick my way through here. And man, I just didn't want to sit home today. You ever had that where you want to go somewhere? And I live on the south side of Phoenix. So, you know, I've got to go all the way across town just to get on 17 to get to see some of these places. And sometimes that's as much a pain than any. But we're working our way down this hill now, if you'll see. Getting close to getting there. There's where I came from. And there's a Jeep right down there. Here's a guy coming down here. And this should be interesting to see. It's almost like there's stuff everywhere down here. It's just crazy. There's people everywhere. And I'm not used to, I'm used to having Agua Fria on my own, but there he is coming down the hill. And that's a rough hill, but you know, he's in a Jeep, should be fine. Wow, that soil was really nice and moist. Cat claws are pretty good. Here, I've hit the bottom now. So I'm gonna walk through here. So we're over here. And now what we're gonna do is walk through here and come up on the road. We should be seeing a Jeep. Like I said, I'm used to, man, I'm used to seeing nobody down here. This is kind of crazy. Should have a Jeep coming across here pretty quick, but There's the ridge line right there. Look how magnificent that ridge line looks. And we're gonna keep walking this road now until we get to the Brooklyn Mine. It should be right over there. And I'm gonna hustle today because, so I apologize already if I'm huffing and puffing because, you know, I've seen fresh tracks, so maybe I could have drove down here. We'll find out, but I'm glad you guys have decided to take a hike with me today. You came out with me, and we should be able to see a lot of different interesting, you know, mining equipment, hopefully some good remnants of the mine. You know, one of the most phenomenal things to me is that how all this stuff matches. So you have water, which is the key ingredient, which brings ancients, which also brings miners, because there's always mines somewhere around water. So it's always been fascinating how all this just kind of goes together. And I'll be curious to see if that Jeep catches me, only because they don't know for sure. It was just as easy as to walk this thing as it was to actually drive down it. And I don't mind exercise as long as you guys are coming with me today. So let's just take a look at what we got right there. So maybe it was a hell of a lot. Maybe it would have been easier to drive, because now they're leaving me in the dust. So we'll just have to see. Right up here is where I thought I saw UTVs blocked when I was working that rim up there. I saw UTVs turning around up here. So, you know, maybe it still would have been better to ride this road, and because now he's pulling way ahead of me. So, well, you live and learn, right? Well, we're getting down here. The Jeep stopped. It probably could have made it, but it would have been pretty hairy. And not everybody's vehicle set up to do this stuff. You know, there's a limit. Some guys, man, it don't matter. They can do it all. You know, some guys aren't going to go to that level. And I get it both ways. But so we're coming up here on this area. I'm a little out of breath, not terrible, but time has got me today. So I'm trying to get moving so we can take you with us and see everything we need to see. Oh, look at this building down here. You just don't know what you're going to find when you go to these places. You just don't. You just don't know what's down the next turn. There's the other road you could have taken out. So we'll see where that goes. Looks like some more remnants over on that hill. I'm going to guess this was a pretty big dam operation. So let's go ahead and take a look. Oh, I love the style. I love these old bricks, or not rocks, I should say. I love the whole skill set. You know, and that's what's funny is, you know, they built just like the ancients did. You know, now they're using concrete, but they built just like the ancients did. Look at this. Got a concrete floor. How cool is that? How cool is this? Holy smokes. There's an old bed. Look at this place. This place is fabulous. Look at this. Man, this was a nice place. This was not. Look at that shot out the back door. Look at that. Unreal. Wow, look at this place. Man. Now if these walls could talk, holy smoke. Look at this. Look how well built this thing was. Man, they weren't messing around. This thing was here to last. How cool is this? Man. Wow. This is a big place, man. They concreted this floor. The amount of work it took to mix all that concrete, man. Let's go over here. Looks like an old ice box. Let's take a look and see what it really is. I love these old rusty junk piles. Yes, what it was. Okay, so. Okay, you don't have a refrigerator. without gas or electricity. So what was it? I don't see any electrical poles other than on that hill. So they would have had been running gasoline compressors and or gas of some type. Now look at that right there. That is pretty cool because that's some type of duct system. As crazy as that sounds, we've stumbled across something that's a lot newer than I think it is, or these guys were pretty damn ingenious on what they did and how they did it. Look at that wall there. Isn't that beautiful? Man, this is awesome. They had a couple king-size beds. Wow, how incredible is this? Okay, there's the well. Absolutely. Still got a ton of water in it. There, they've got all kinds of stuff going on over here. This place is really, that duct system, that sure looks like that what that is. And you know, so again, I haven't done research, I just wanted to come see an old mine. Look at this here. I don't know what this part was, some type of pantry of some type. Those remnants are pretty old. But, oh, look at that rabbit. He doesn't know what to do. He's kind of stuck in here. Might be hiding from stuff that's out to get him. So let's go take a look. You know, you take this ride in and you think of anything that they had to haul in here. And what a pain in the ass that would have been. But I guess when you don't know any better, you know, you don't know any better. Not that you don't know any better, there isn't any better. Yeah, this hill is definitely terraced for machinery, whether it be some type of stamp mill or something of that nature. Looks like we found one of the mines right here. Had a fence around it one time. And either got caved in or it filled in. We're gonna take a walk over there. There's another concrete building over there. So we know there's another mine in this area somewhere. With most of these places, they're all over. So we definitely wanna make sure that you keep your eyes peeled. And the nice thing is look at this soil. This isn't like the Agua Fria soil down in this this creek bed. You know, it's pretty nice walking. It's not nearly. There's a big fire ring right there, whether that be newer or older. So we know there were ancients in this area a long time before the more modern man came to mine this. So now that is a pretty impressive pile of tailings. And there's some cans down here. I'm gonna work my way up. There looks the easiest, and we will see what's up there. Isn't that cool? That's an awesome piece right there. Look at that. That is nice. I like that. Looks like we got a bunch of that. Okay, here we go again. That. Well, I'm glad you guys got to come out here with me today. If you didn't get to get out today, glad you were able to come out with me. Makes it a lot nicer when you got people coming with me. So looky here, this is a pretty damn big pile. Probably a beam to that house or beam to one of the mines. Look at this. This is a, here we go. Ooh, There we are. There's the mine. Right there. Look at that dude. That's pretty serious. Wow, that's pretty awesome. Man, don't want to fall into that dude. Wow, that's cool. Take a look at that. That is awesome. Man, you just don't never know what you're gonna see out here. That's what's so cool about this. We're gonna walk around this. You know, you see all the material they've taken out of this. Man, they weren't playing around. They were, look at this wall, basically they built. And then look at all this. It's been pulled out of that hole. You know, there's no hardware store. You know, whatever you needed, you had to build it. Figure out how to build it. And, you know, you were on your own. You couldn't run down to Payless or Lowe's or any of those stores to grab a nut or a bolt. You had to build it. And it's just funny how, you know, they build the same kind of walls. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Man, that's cool. This is kind of a weird structure, but look how good that wall's lasted all these years. Man, that's awesome. That is absolutely awesome. Man, all kinds of stuff going on here. I would have loved to have seen this place back in the day. This was a pretty cool structure. Looks like we got another mine over here. This looks like it was some type of mine right there. And then this concrete building. I'm gonna maybe dynamite? Maybe? It's a hell of a building. Holy smokes. Look at the thickness in this thing. Wow. Man, oh, god dang. Okay, so I don't know what kind he is. I can't see, is he dead? Anybody saw that? He looks like a Mojave sitting back there. Look at that dude. So it happens when you crawl into holes. Right there. Yeah, he's alive. I can't tell if he's a Mojave or not. I don't want to piss him off too much. But there he was. So, we'll let him be. Now, there was a fence around here for some reason, right here. God only knows why. Kind of funny though, because it doesn't look like there's any structures. You know, and there's a perfect example. It looked like a Mojave. It might not have been a Mojave. But, you know, snakes around here, they're not used to people. So they don't really rattle unless they feel like they're threatened. And he didn't feel like he was threatened. So that old myth about, you know, rattlesnakes rattling, man, don't wait for that to come true, because you won't always see that. So, you might just make sure that you keep your eyes peeled. Now, I'm pretty excited about going up on that ridge that is right up there also, if you'll see it, up along there. I got a weird feeling where you're gonna find some stuff. Oh, man, ow. See that low cat claw right there? That dude just gets you. And that goes right through your pants. Now it looks like they were doing all kinds of stuff over here. We're heading right there. See that chimney? Again, it looks like a chimney. It could be a smelter stack. I don't know. And but we're gonna take a look. That'll be the loop of Brooklyn. We've got to see the house. We've got to see the mine. Got to see the tailings. Got to see what I think is the area they would have stored the dynamite. And we got saw a snake. And how fun is that for a hell of a building? But see, I don't see a foundation around it, so I'm automatically thinking that that's some type of smelter. There was a sign up there at one time that said something, you know, whether it be a mine or something like that. We're gonna have to take a look and see if we can still see anything or not. Are these ruins right here? They sure are. Oh my gosh, I didn't know this existed. You have got to be kidding me. Look at this. Holy smoke. I didn't even know this existed. I thought that there were remnants on top of that hill, but I didn't know anything about here. Look at this. Man, how cool is this? That sign had to have said, and there's another one over there, had to have said that there's ruins. Now that one over there is marked with the newer ruin sign, but wow. So look, here's a ring. Now this could have been an ancient ring, and it could have been not so ancient ring right here. Definitely was a ring. Could have been a fire pit for these guys here, but look how close these guys. There's more ruins right there. This is all ruins through here. Now, I thought they were on top of that hill, and they're definitely not, but then here's this big structure that they put in here, right here. This is unbelievable. Wow. Had a mantle on it, so it definitely is a fireplace. I'm gonna guess, I'm guessing again, but there's the mantle right there. Look at this thing. Look how long that thing's hung up there. Look at the piece of steel. Holy smoke. That's unbelievable. And these guys are right next to the Indian ruins. So, by gosh, if that didn't give them nightmares. You know, what's funny is, this looks like more of the foundation area there. And this being the back. But, you know, that'd be a funny way for that to be. Wow, how crazy is that? Now, I did not expect to run into all these ruins. And look at the rocks they chose for this fireplace. Isn't that beautiful? That is unbelievable. Look at those. Wow. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. And then we're going to quit bitching and start hiking. So I'm looking up that hill, and even in here, as I stumble through here, I'm seeing pottery shards, and I'm still like, shouldn't be any pottery shards up this hill. So what we're gonna do is, you know, that looks like a wall up on that ridge. And the weird thing is, it could be rocks, just nature, but look at these pots. I mean, I'm seeing pottery shards all over here. Now there is the ruins down below by that chimney, right? I'm uphill now. There's no possible way that those shards were gonna get over here. So, my gut is telling me that, like it or not, our destiny is on the top of that hill right there. Taking a little breather, I'm breathing hard, probably halfway up. That's what I'm seeing. But you know, it's the craziest thing. Look here, look at this. Okay, I'm not even close to anything. So, I'm halfway up this mountain, and I'm seeing shards everywhere. So, we got Indian ruins up top. And there's just no doubt in my mind that there's gonna be a large quantity, because you don't find this many remnants unless they had a lot of stuff going on. So I'm gonna shut you off a little bit, and then I'm gonna get up there, and because now the adrenaline has kicked in, and I'm pretty excited about reaching the top. Man, look at that. There's a truck way over there on Brooklyn, But along this ledge, all the way through here, look at these ruins. They're all over here. This is unbelievable. Wow, I knew when I was down below and I was seeing all that, I was like, I know that I'm in a big area. I'm in an area. I know I am. I mean, I could feel it. And I'm telling you what, this is absolutely unreal. Unreal. Look at this. Man, look at the view. There's the foundation. There is the fireplace. The mine's over there. Wow. Look how crazy. And then we had ruins down below, right? You can see them. They look small from up here, but wow, this whole ledge, all the way through here, all the way running down this ledge, this reminds me of Sears K. I mean, it really does. Look at all this. This is crazy. Look at this. Look at this. Oh my gosh. I can't even believe this. Man, you've got to be kidding me. And I was afraid to walk it up here, try to get up here on the top so I can kill you. Look at these walls. Look at this. Oh my gosh. I can't even talk. That, look at this wall over here. We got to go around to see that. Oh, this place is spectacular. Look at this. This is absolutely unreal. They're just, Agua Fria just completely blows you away. Every time you think you've seen something or you've seen it, and the amount of pottery shards that I'm finding is, you know, this was a big, big deal. Big deal. I got to figure a way to walk around there. They've got this place pretty well figured out. Well, I had to get to way down below to come on to stay off those walls to get down this end, and I'm huffing and puffing. I just looked at my clock and it's 3 o'clock. It's probably going to take me an hour to get back. Hour to get back the freeway. I'm going to be losing light here pretty quick. I need to make my way. Look how far. It just goes all the way around. And you can see the truck way over there shining. So, you know, it just means that there's stuff everywhere. Look at that wall. I think this is the last one. Look at that wall. Look at this place. It's up on this mountain. Look at their view. It's what they had to look at every day. Look at this. Look at these walls. Boy, if that isn't awe-inspiring, I really don't know what is, because we'll work our way down this ledge off that wall, work our way around so we stay off of it. You want those things to last as long as you possibly can, because this is a gem. This is a gem. Look at this. Look at the size of this place. It's unreal. Look at that. Unreal. Unreal. Okay, there is something else incredible. There is a concrete dam, if you guys can see that. We'll have to save that for another day, but that's a concrete dam down there that was working on this mining operation. So they had stuff going on. You see an animal trail down there. It might have been an ancient trail too. That road goes up to that. Look at that. It's a concrete dam. You can imagine the amount of effort it took to build that. You have got to be kidding me. That is unbelievable. Wow. It just goes on and on and on. This place is absolutely spectacular. We're going to try to work our way down. You only know what you'll find up here. We're going to work our way around and get heading back to the truck. But I'll tell you what. We got a dam down there. We got all those structures with mining. We got these ruins. We've got one of the bigger ruins that I've run across. And I'm telling you what, it's unbelievable. How incredible is this? I tell you what, I'm awe-inspired today. My gosh. You know, we saw it all today, you know. And then finish it off with a dam, which means that, you know, always gives you a reason that you got to come back is, you know, you see that dam, but I'm up here looking at this ridge and I'm just like, you have got to be kidding me. You know, and there's more mines here And I know that to be a fact. Well, here we are. We have a choice to make right here. There is the easier way, going down that trail, and then we'll go up on the other side of that ridge. Gonna be easy walking, gonna be nice. I ain't probably even gonna sweat. Probably gonna be easy. Probably gonna take about 15, 20 minutes more. Okay, there is the harder, stupider way, where we're gonna get cat claw. We don't know exactly where we're gonna get out at. We don't know exactly how we're gonna go in. And we're gonna get the shit beat out of us, but it's gonna take us about 15 minutes less. So, well, what do we wanna do? It's up to you. I'll do either. That's what I figured. You wanna go the harder way. You wanna go the harder way. You wanna go up there. So, we're gonna cut down this creek. Man, I kinda wanna go that way. But you have spoken and you said you wanted to go this way. Now I know coming down it sucked. Going up probably actually a little better traction. But you say go up, this is what we do. So here we go. Well, there's where we went down from up here, down that valley, up that valley, up that ridge there, down that ridge, and then right back up there. And I tell you what, I appreciate the help because I wouldn't have made it. So I appreciate you guys pushing me. Now I'm going to show you a little, got an old shit rock I just stood on. There's three men right there, right? There's the man with big hands. I don't have big hands, but here's, now I thought I saw a bee going in here. So if you see us run, you know why. But I'm going to get down here on this ledge right here. And look at that. Sit down here on this rock, and I tell you what, petroglyphs right there too, all on this ridge, all through here. You know, they were all over, man. They were over here. This was neighborhoods. It's exactly what it was. Look how beautiful that is. And sun's getting ready to start to go down, and we're back up top. Man, you know, if you enjoyed this, please like. You know, the other thing you can do is share. If you can help me build this channel, I would definitely appreciate it. And if you hit that notification bell over there, that tells you when we put videos out. But I can already tell you, we put out every Monday and every Thursday at 4:30 p.m. So if you'd like to see it, you definitely can. We're back. All my partners in crime are gone. The party's done. There's the truck. Always a great sign. I want to thank you guys for coming along at the Brooklyn Mine and actually Brooklyn Ruins. So how incredible is this? What a great day today, man. Thanks for coming along. And I'll catch my breath eventually. Got a long ride home, so I have plenty of time to catch my breath. Jace Wreck, Black Flags Expeditions. Thanks for coming along, man. It was awesome. Now we're heading that way.